हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल फूड टेक बड़ी बाय मोदी धोखा। स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रोटीन्स। यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड दैट प्रोटीन्स आर द पॉलीमर्स ऑफ अल्फा अमीनो एसिड्स एंड दे आर कनेक्टेड टू ईच अदर बाय पेप्टाइड बॉन्ड और पेप्टाइड लिंकेज। केमिकली पेप्टाइड लिंकेज इज एन अमाइड फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन सी डब्ल्यू एच ग्रुप एंड एन एच टू ग्रुप। द रिएक्शन बिटवीन टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ सिमिलर और डिफरेंट अमीनो एसिड प्रोसीड्स थ्रू द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द अमीनो ग्रुप ऑफ वन मॉलिक्यूल विद द कार्बोक्सिल ग्रुप ऑफ द अदर। This results in the elimination of a water molecule and the formation of a peptide bond CONH. The product of the reaction is called a dipeptide because it is made up of two amino acids. For example, when carboxyl group of glycine combines with the amino group of alanine, we get a dipeptide glycylalanine. If a third amino acid combines to a dipeptide, the product is called a tripeptide. A tripeptide contains three amino acids linked by two peptide linkages. Similarly, when 4, 5 or 6 amino acids are linked, the respective products are known as tetrapeptide, pentapeptide or hexapeptide respectively. When the number of such amino acids is more than 10, then the products are called polypeptides. A polypeptide with more than 100 amino acid residues having molecular mass higher than 10,000 mu is called a protein. However, the distinction between a polypeptide and a protein is not very sharp. Polypeptide with fewer amino acids are likely to be called proteins if they ordinarily have a well-defined conformation of a protein, such as insulin, which contains 51 amino acids. Proteins can be classified into two types on the basis of their molecular shape. Fibrous proteins. When the polypeptide chains run parallel and are held together by hydrogen and disulfide bonds, then fiber-like structure is formed. Such proteins are generally insoluble in water. Some common examples are keratin, present in hair, wool, silk, and myosin, present in muscles, etc. Globular proteins. This structure results when the chains of polypeptides coil around to give a spherical shape. These are usually soluble in water. Insulin and albumin are the common examples of globular proteins. Structure and shape of proteins can be studied at four different levels: primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. Each level being more complex than the previous one. Primary structure of proteins. Proteins may have one or more polypeptide chains. Each polypeptide in a protein has amino acids linked with each other in a specific sequence, and it is this sequence of amino acids that is said to be primary structure of that protein. Any change in this primary structure, the sequence of amino acids creates a different protein. Secondary structure of a protein. Of proteins. The secondary structure of protein refers to the shape in which a long polypeptide chain can exist. They are found to exist in two different types of structures, viz. Alpha helix and beta pleated sheet structure. These structures arise due to the regular folding of the backbone of the polypeptide chain due to hydrogen bonding between C double bond O and NH groups of the peptide bond. Alpha helix structure of protein. Alpha helix is one of the most common ways in which a polypeptide chain forms all possible hydrogen bonds by twisting into a right-handed screw helix with the NH group of each amino acid residue hydrogen bonded to the C double bond O of an adjacent turn of the helix. In beta structure, all peptide chains are stretched out to nearly maximum extension and then laid side by side, which are held together by intermolecular hydrogen bonds. The structure resembles the pleated folds of the drapery and therefore is known as beta pleated sheet. Tertiary structure of proteins. The tertiary structure of proteins represents overall folding of the polypeptide chains. Further folding of the secondary structure. It gives rise to the two major molecular shapes, viz. Fibrous and globular. The main forces which stabilize the 2 degree and 3 degree structures of proteins are hydrogen bonds, disulfide linkages, van der Waals and electrostatic forces of attraction. Quaternary structure of proteins. Some of the proteins are composed of two or more polypeptide chains referred to as subunits. The spatial arrangement of these subunits with respect to each other is known as quaternary structure. Beta pleated sheet structure of the proteins. A diagrammatic representation of all these four structures is given below, where each colored ball represents an amino acid, primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure and quaternary structure. Diagrammatic representation of protein structure. Two subunits of two types in the quaternary structure. Primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary structures of hemoglobin. Primary structure consisting of carbon and hydrogen. Secondary structure consisting of nitrogen and oxygen. Tertiary structure consisting of R groups and heme groups. एंड क्वार्टरनरी स्ट्रक्चर. डीनेचुरेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन्स. प्रोटीन फाउंड इन अ बायोलॉजिकल सिस्टम विद अ यूनिक थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर एंड अ बायोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटी इज कॉल्ड अ नेटिव प्रोटीन. व्हेन अ प्रोटीन इन इट्स नेटिव फॉर्म इज सब्जेक्टेड टू फिजिकल चेंज लाइक चेंज इन टेम्परेचर और केमिकल चेंजेस लाइक चेंज इन पीएच द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड्स आर डिस्टर्ब. ड्यू टू दिस ग्लोब्यूल्स अनफोल्ड एंड हेलिक्स गेट अनकॉइल्ड एंड प्रोटीन लूजेस इट्स बायोलॉजिकल एक्टिविटी. दिस इज कॉल्ड डीनेचुरेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन. ड्यूरिंग डीनेचुरेशन 2 degree एंड 3 degree structures are destroyed, but 1T structure remains intact. The coagulation of egg white on boiling is a common example of denaturation. Another example is curdling of milk, which is caused due to formation of lactic acid by the bacteria present in the milk. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you.